这个活动的话主要是来邀请一些海外的朋友，然后再邀请我们本地的一些居民来参加，然后来介绍一些我们这个中国的扇子文化的这个历史。
I've learned how to write on the fans, and I've also learned how the fans were used in the ancient time in China. Some of the fans were used to fan the empire in the dynasty, and the other fans were used by some other ladies to hide themselves from other people because they were a bit shy. Then the other fans were just owned by any other person, any other civil servant. They used to use it to fan themselves when they are thinking or when they are relaxing. They'll just fan themselves for a short time.
我们还邀请了我们的这个书画室的一些老师傅，然后来教我们的居民自己 DIY 这个扇子。
因为他们跟我们生活习惯不一样，文字的那个使用也不一样，刚开始他们很不适应的。第一步，哪一笔先下，哪一笔后下，教他，他能够知道。他往往是先写这边，后写这边，他们也是反的，这样是慢慢的跟他们融合一下就好了。
My feelings were so excited. It was fun seeing them paint, seeing them draw. Like, it just made me, you know more about the Chinese culture. And I was trying to connect with what I learned during my lessons in class about Chinese culture and how you need to draw and to write the characters. And yeah.
中国这个书法艺术的话，必须要有红颜色来点缀，是吧？因为墨是黑的，你有红在上面，就使得你的画面呢就增色不少。我们就用它的小拇指、小指头蘸一点那个印泥，盖在上面就有一个红色了，这他们的指纹也留在上面去了，更有意义。